Chapter 6. Wandering. God's Brave Explorers. Numbers 13. After traveling in the wilderness, Moses and the Israelites reached the edge of Canaan, the land God had promised his people. The weary travelers were excited to know their journey was almost over. Moses called the people together. "Before we enter this promised land, we must send explorers to learn about the land and the people who live there," he said. Moses chose 12 explorers and gave them instructions. "Go south and then to the mountains," he said. "See what the land looks like. Is the soil rich for planting? Are there lots of trees? Are the people strong or weak? What are the towns like? Are they open like camps, or do they have walls?" The 12 explorers packed up. Off they went. They searched and looked and investigated for 40 days. Then they returned to Moses with a report. "The land is awesome," said the explorers. "The soil is good for planting. Just taste these wonderful fruits we found, grapes, pomegranates, and figs." They shared their treasures with the people. The Israelites couldn't wait to enter the land. Excitement grew among the people. But when Moses asked about the Canaanites who lived in the new land, the explorers began to disagree. 10 were fearful and told the others, "We can't go there. The cities are huge and they have tall walls around them. The people are big and strong. Some are as big as giants. They will kill us if we try to take their land," they cried. The fears of the 10 explorers quickly spread through the camp. "We were better off back in Egypt living as slaves," the people protested. But 2 explorers, Caleb and Joshua, were not afraid. They were strong and brave, and they trusted God. "We can do it. We can take the land. The Lord is on our side. Don't be afraid of the people. They have no protection, but the Lord is with us." Despite all the good things God had done for his people, the people did not believe Caleb and Joshua. God was angry with the Israelites' lack of faith. Moses pleaded with God to forgive the people. God listened to Moses and agreed to forgive. But God did not allow his people to enter the land for another 40 years. A good man makes a mistake. Numbers 21-13. Moses tried to be a good leader. He carefully followed God's instructions. He helped the people remember all of God's rules. When the Israelites grumbled, he tried to be patient, but Moses didn't always succeed. The Israelites could not find water in the desert. Once again, the people forgot how God had provided for them throughout their journey. They fussed and complained. They blamed Moses. "We'll die in this desert if you don't find us water. We should have stayed in Egypt." Moses listened. Then, as always, he went to God. He asked God to provide water for the people. God answered his prayer, "Gather the people around," God instructed. "Take your walking stick and go to a rock I will show you. Talk to the rock, and water will flow." Moses and his brother Aaron gathered the people who were still griping and grumbling. Moses became angry and lost his temper. He shouted at the people for not trusting God. Then Moses smacked the rock twice with his stick. Immediately water gushed out of the rock, enough for all the people and animals. The people received what they needed, but Moses was punished for his action. Moses had disobeyed God and hadn't given him credit for the miracle. God said, "Because you did not believe me, and because you did not honor me as holy before the people, you will not lead them into the land I will give them." Moses remained the leader of the people of Israel, but because of his mistake, his leadership ended at the edge of the promised land.